Want some fried chicken in your life, but don't want all the grease? I got you. Today I'm gonna show you how to get ultimate crispy, tasty fried chicken right in your air fryer. My name is Kathy, and I'm here to help you actually use your air fryer. If you've seen my other air fryer recipes, you know I'm all about simple and easy. And this fried chicken recipe, it absolutely passes the test. Are you ready? Let's go. First things first, we're gonna get some buttermilk ready. Now, do I ever have buttermilk on hand? No. So I always do this simple substitute. And since this recipe is calling for 1.5 cups of buttermilk, I'm just adding 1.5 teaspoons of lemon juice to my milk today. And then it's time to get your spice mixture ready. Simply combine 1 tablespoon of each. I've got smoked paprika. You can use regular if you can't find smoked. Black pepper, salt, onion powder, then garlic powder. Whisk all of that up and set it aside. And now that your fake buttermilk is ready, add in anywhere from 2 tablespoons to 1/4 cup of hot sauce. If you don't want a little kick in your chicken, you can leave this part out. Whisk that all up together and then get a spoon because you're gonna put half of the spice mixture right here into your marinade. You call it a marinade, call it a brine, whatever you want. This is what our chicken is gonna soak in and it's gonna make the meat so tender and packed with flavor. Now that it's ready, get 2 to 3 pounds of chicken drumsticks or thighs and add it to the brine. So 8 drumsticks, and you can see it's totally overflowing my bowl here. Although I like to use dishes, in this case, I'm gonna grab a Ziploc bag because I want the chicken to soak evenly. And to make things easier, I'm using my handy dandy bag holder. I'm gonna use tongs and transfer this over, and hello, no, apparently this is not very helpful. Oh, I'm doing great with my coordination today. As I look at this bowl and see all of these spices in it, I think that putting it in the bag is a better call because as the chicken is soaking in this bag, I can flip it around to redistribute the spices. I'm gonna let this soak for at least 1 hour or 2. You could even let this soak overnight. While that is soaking, I'm gonna make my dredge mixture. I'm gonna get another clean, handy bag holder. Just add 1.5 cups of flour to the bag, and then you're gonna add 1/2 cup of cornstarch. Cornstarch in this mixture is gonna give that extra boost of crisp, but if you don't have it, you can just do 2 cups of flour total. I'm gonna add just 1 teaspoon of baking powder. This is also gonna help crisp up that outer layer. Drop in the remaining spices, close up your bag, and mix that up nice and good. When that's all shooken up, just set it aside. It's ready to go. Now you could make some sides for your dinner or just go put your feet up and binge watch your favorite air fryer channel. Okay, this bag has been resting a couple hours now. It's time to start the double dip dredging process. What do you think? Can I do 2 at a time? Kind of really enjoy saving time. Just have fun with it. Does that look appetizing or what? All right, let's see if I can do 3 at a time. I'm a little lazy in the kitchen. There we go. All 8 shaggy little pieces of my drumsticks. Time to start the double dip. Preheat that air fryer. Keeping up with my pure lazy cooking, I'm gonna try and get multiple legs in the bag. It's working just fine. Plenty of room. Now it's time to spray your chicken with some avocado oil. I usually use my cute little Misto can here, but this avocado spray from Trader Joe's sprays pretty heavy. There's no propellants or chemicals in here. It might look like a lot, but it's honestly not much compared to deep frying this chicken. Just make sure you coat all the flour. That's gonna help it adhere to the chicken and get nice and crispy. Place your chicken in the air fryer. Preset says 380 for 25 minutes for chicken, but I found that it actually needs just about 15 or 16 minutes at 380. You'll wanna check it at the halfway point to give it a flip if it needs it. And let's take a peek. If you see white flour, just give it another squirt there and let it finish up cooking. And check it out. Listen to that crispiness. It's amazing. You've got to see all the different ways you can use your air fryer. Check out this playlist right here. I'll see you on the next video.